Hey guys, now you can follow me on Facebook. Just go to facebook.com/UltraMaximusReviews.
Oh hey, it's the police! Me's a safe!
Bruh, he's got a stabbing knife. And he's wearing a pair of OJ murder gloves.
Ow! 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 Ow!
You suck.
You were awesome in 6 feet under. Hold up, we're cool.
Ultra Maximus back with another 31 Horror Toys in 31 Days! And today we're taking a look at a figure, I believe it's from Bif Pow. It's Dexter from Dexter, the TV series from Showtime. Now, I found this figure at my local flea market, and it's obviously not in the original packaging. It's still in the bubble case, but somebody took saran wrap and wrapped it all around the figure, which unto itself is kind of cool because if you ever watched Dexter, that's what he would do with his victims. He would like cover everything in saran wrap and saran wrap them down and kill them. So the fact that the thing's in saran wrap just has an extra creepy cool factor for me. So let's go ahead and take a look at the quote-unquote packaging. So here we have Dexter in its not original packaging, but he's in his bubble card and he still has all the accessories, which I really do dig. He's even got the twist ties holding him in. Somebody went ahead and saran wrapped it so that nothing fell out, which was very nice of them. I paid $10 for the figure, which it's about what it goes for online. There's really nothing on the thing. It's just straight saran wrapped. So just kind of a close up. There he is. He's got his knife and he's got his badge and his little trash bag of parts. He's got some alternate hands, which look kind of cool. But yeah, definitely kind of fun that it's all saran wrapped up, a la his victims from the show. So let's go ahead and get Dexter out of packaging and see what we think. So let's go ahead and get Dexter unwrapped and see what we think. So here we have Dexter out of the packaging, and I gotta say, he is one menacing psychopath. I mean, he just has this really nice kind of stance where he's just looking down and he's about to murder someone. So I guess that's pretty accurate. Now he does come with some really cool accessories. First off, he comes with some alternate hands here, which is very nice. He's got his sleeves rolled up, and then this one's got a little watch on it, just kind of a close-up. Yeah. Pretty cool, silver painted, everything looks really neat, really nice. They just kind of pop on and off the shoulders here, which seem very difficult to do. I tried doing that, and it felt like I was going to break one of the arms, so I'm not going to do it because the figure's kind of old. And I like him with the gloved hands. Every time I watch the show and I see him go to kill someone, he's always got those black gloves on, so that's definitely the way I'm going to leave him here. He also comes with a little trash bag right here filled with body parts, and it actually does look like a trash bag to me. So that is really cool. I definitely dig that. I'm pretty sure he can hold the trash bag if you wanted to, but I just kind of like it sitting there next to him. And then the arms here look like they could be some extra body parts from somebody he's cut up. And then he's also got his knife, which I've got in his hand right there, which is very, very cool. It fits very snugly into the hand, which I like. It seems like a lot of the times these little accessories like knives and guns just don't fit into the hands, and they did a good job getting that to work. The other thing that's really cool is his police name badge. You can't really see much detail, but it works for what it is. But it's got a thread for the lanyard, which is really nice and kind of gives it a very cool, realistic kind of look. And that's definitely different. Usually those things are just really thin plastic. Alright, so as far as articulation goes, he really doesn't have that much. Which is a bit unfortunate. So to look at the figure here, his head does move back and forth. It does not move up or down. His arms move up like this. They do not move out at all. He has a single joint at his elbow. There is no twist at the waist. The hands do not twist. There's nothing at the legs, nothing at the knees, and nothing at the feet. So he is really, for all practical tents and purposes, a little plastic statue. So, yeah, that's all the articulation that he's got, which is a damn shame. To be honest, it makes me want Nika to go back and redo this figure in its Real Toys line. I think they would do a much better job. But then again, this figure is a little bit on the older side. So what are you gonna do? So taking a closer look at the figure itself, the sculpt on the head is decent. It's not the greatest. It looks enough like the actor that it's passable. What I do like about it is the pose that it's in, how it's kind of angled down, and all the shadows really take advantage of that sculpt work, which is nice. He's got the gray shirt with the white outlines, which is very cool. The haircut looks like the one that Dexter had in the show. I'd like a little bit more paint apps on him, especially in the hair. I think that would work really well. He's got a very nice detail in the texture of the shirt itself. I'm definitely digging that. The buttons on the shirt there look really nice in its sculpt work and paint job. And the fact that they use an actual thread for his lanyard on his badge, I think that is pretty cool. It's definitely different. And I guess if it broke, you can always get some more thread and re-thread the badge. So taking a look at the midsection of the figure, love the black gloves. Like the white details on the shirt again. The badge hanging off looks really nice. There's not a lot of detail in it, but far enough away, I mean, it looks right. Definitely digging that. The wrinkles in the shirt around his waist look nice. The pants, they look like the proper color. They've got some nice detail on there. But yeah, the wrinklage all the way around the shirt, I like that, the way it's kind of hitting the curves on his body, underneath his armpits, everywhere. That all looks good. The blade itself is a little thick, I think, but, you know, it's not going to be one to break pretty quick. At least it's painted silver, it's got a nice black hilt, and it fits snug into the hands. And finally, taking a look at the legs of the figure. Again, the cargo pants look good. I like the detail, the pockets on it, the seams, the way it hangs, all the wrinkles look good. The shoes look really good. They look like shoes, brown leather. That's nice. It'd been cool if they would have painted the shoelaces on there. I mean, there's a lot of detail everywhere else. I'm not sure why they didn't there. The black soles look good. It changes up the color and matches, you know, the shoes that he wore on the show. The back of the cuffs on the pants, how they go down to the back of the shoes. It's the way most of my pants seem to hang on me. But yeah, overall, it looks good. The problem is there is zero articulation in this portion of the figure, which is a bit of a disappointment. For comparison, and as you can see, Dexter does fit into scale with him, so that's nice. I think I'll probably put them up on the shelf together, my psychopath shelf. I guess I'll make one of those with like Leatherface and my other movie maniacs. And as you can see, Dexter does fit into scale with him, so that's nice. I think I'll probably put them up on the shelf together, my psychopath shelf. I guess I'll make one of those with like Leatherface and my other movie maniacs. But alas, he just does not have the same articulation that old Negan's got here. But then again, Negan's a lot newer figure. So is Dexter a figure that you want in your horror collection? If you love the TV show Dexter, this is probably something that you're going to like. You know, I really like the show, at least the first few seasons of it. It got kind of out there for me and just a little wishy-washy when he had the kid and got married and all that jazz. But the first few seasons were amazeballs. And I do like the character. I think it's a lot of fun. It's a different kind of character, and it was a phenomenon show on Showtime. The articulation on the figure is very lacking. It does need an update. I'd really like to see Nika take a swing at it. I think they could, you know, go from this and just really enhance the figure. As it stands, it's not a bad figure, but it's really more or less a plastic statue. You know, that being said, I love the trash bag and the accessories. The lanyard, I really like. He does have the interchangeable arms, but this figure just really doesn't seem to want to swap the parts out. It's probably due to the age. And I want to say there was a blood splatter version of this figure, but I don't know. Leave a comment below if that's right or wrong. So, yeah, there he is, Dexter, for 31 horror toys in 31 days!
Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you like this video, thumbs it up. If you hate this video, thumbs it down. To watch more Ultra Maximus, click on the links to the right. Don't forget to subscribe and share, like us on Facebook, and look for more videos in the future.